In the introduction of part one of Faust, in a dedication, the speaker addresses the ghosts of his youth who have returned to him, making his heart beat with a youth's excitement. His longing turns these vanished ghosts into his present reality. In the prelude in the theater, the manager of a theater company, a poet, that is a playwright, and a clown, an actor, are discussing what theater's all about. The manager wants to make sure they fill the seats with an eager audience. The poet wants to write something of lasting literary value. To the clown, he just wants a big crowd. The manager wants plenty of action and says the audience is not truly interested in the play. Their minds are elsewhere. The manager tells the poet to devise a good play that will take the audience from heaven through this, our world, down to hell. In the prologue in heaven, the three archangels, Raphael, Gabriel, and Michael, talk about the weather and praise the Lord's creation, but are not pleased by the dark storms afflicting land and sea alike. Mephistopheles comes forward and talks directly to the Lord. Mephistopheles feels sorry for humanity and hates having to torment them. The Lord says he's sick of hearing the same complaints all the time. The two discuss Faust. Mephistopheles thinks Faust is crazy, but the Lord believes he'll turn out all right. Mephistopheles bets that if the Lord doesn't interfere, he will be able to seduce Faust away from righteousness. The Lord accepts the wager. The tone of the dedication to Faust is serious and the atmosphere nostalgic, but the tone of the opening scene of part one is light and humorous. It seems to make fun of the poet's sensitive nature. A play is not only about the written word, Goethe reminds the audience, it's also about acting, stagecraft, and the needs of the audience. The final few lines introduce the plot of Faust and lead directly into the setting of the prologue in heaven, which introduces the main characters of the play, Mephistopheles and Faust, and the main conflict, the wager for Faust's soul. Mephistopheles, rather than appearing as a creature of power or evil, has a self-deprecating humor that makes him likable. He's the only one in the prologue who shows true compassion for humanity. Faust's pursuit of knowledge will lead him to indulge in a wide variety of questionable actions. Through those actions and their repercussions, Goethe explores several of his dominant themes: pursuit of knowledge, man's inhumanity to man, and sin and redemption.